My name is Marcus Walters. I'm going to tell you about my journey.
I'm coming home.
I miss you so much. I'm so glad you're home. I have so much to tell you. I don't know where to start.
Welcome home, son.
It's good to be home.
I prayed for this moment. God has answered my prayers.
It's good to be home.
I can't wait to get you home. I prepared your favorite meal.
Let's get out of here.
Productions of theater that you really need to go to, and then I have this cheer competition coming up. You really need to go to that because that one's really important.
KJ.
Sorry.
Surprise!
Welcome
home!
Yes!
Marcus is good to see you.
Good to see you.
Making me a little hungry.
Yeah, I'm
well,
hungry.
Well, your grandma already said she's got food at the house.
I'm hungry now. Every day.
Well, you know, you get that from me. I'm always hungry. But I'm hungry for this right here first.
What? Oh my goodness.
So, Jay, so how are you liking your new school? You got any new friends?
Yeah, I actually have a lot of new friends, and I really like my new school.
Oh, that's so great, baby. Well, you know Daddy's hungry, so let's go ahead and get some of your grandmom cooking. Good to see you. I'm just gonna go upstairs and look around, all right?
Okay. You ready?
Oh, all right, Mom. So yes, Lord, we just like to thank you for what you've done, what you're doing now, and what you continue doing in our lives. We give you glory and praise in your mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, what's been going on in the last 18 months since I've been gone?
Thinking about you because I missed you so much.
Miss you too, Mommy.
Hey, Daddy, do you think we can go outside and play?
It's
all right, baby. It's all right. It's all right. I would love to, baby, but I'd talk to you about your grandma, okay?
Mm-hmm. I'm actually not that hungry anymore. Can I excuse you?
Hey, you're not Jamil.
Go ahead, baby.
No, no, go ahead. Thanks, Grandma.
Oh.
Okay.
It's been a rough 18 months. I just don't feel the same anymore. I think I've seen. My thoughts ain't the same. My body feels different. I just don't know.
Marcus, what do you mean you don't feel the same?
Are you okay? You're shaking.
Marcus, can I get you anything? What's wrong?
No, I'm perfect, baby.
Can I
okay.
get you something, Marcus?
Oh, come on, it's me, Mama. It's me. I'm all right. Eat the food you cook for us, baby. It's all right. It's all right, Mama. It's all right. I'm gonna check on Jake. I'm gonna check on Jake. See what it is.
It's been tough for me to sleep. When I was over there, you know, I never slept.
I'm sorry you had to go through all that, but now you're home, safe and sound.
Oh, it's my mom. Hello? Hey, Mama. Oh, I slept like a baby. Okay, no problem. All right, Mama. You have a good day. I love you, all right? All right, bye-bye.
Why'd you tell your mom you slept like a baby?
You already know. If I tell her that I'm not sleeping, it's going to worry her to death. I'd just rather she not know what's going on, and we just keep it that way, all right?
Okay, but she's going to figure out eventually. I mean, you know your mom has that interconnection thing that no one else has.
I just know when the time is right, I'll let her know, okay?
Okay. So do you feel comfortable talking to me about it?
I just feel like it may be best I talk to someone who can handle what I'm telling them.
I can call Dr. Adams to make you an appointment.
I'll try, but if you do it, just try to do it while Jay's in school.
So, help me understand exactly what happened over there.
Well, it started about 6 months while we were in theater. I was seeing some horrific things. I mean, people getting blown up and they're bringing their bodies back in bags, and it was just so much. I thought I could handle it, but when I was just seeing it, it was just tough.
I knew it would be difficult, but I had no idea it would be like that. Thank God the chapter
is
over.
I wish it was over, but you know, that's why I don't sleep no more. I'm shaking and sweating in my sleep. It's tough.
See Dr. Adams.
Okay. Just fill out the paperwork, and when you're finished, just bring it back to me.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Dr. Adams will see you now.
Oh. All right. Thank you, ma'am.
Good morning, Mr. Walters. Thank you for coming in today. Are you comfortable? Is there anything I can get for you?
No, I'm okay.
Great. I was reviewing your file before you got here, and I understand that you served in the military and haven't been home very long. That means a lot to me. I want to say thank you for that. I appreciate your service.
You're welcome, Doctor. I can't think straight. I'm jumpy at times. I can't have a good conversation with anybody, and sometimes I feel like I'm about to die.
I hate to hear that. That sounds like you're having a tough time. I've seen this kind of thing way too often. Have you ever heard of the term PTSD?
Yeah, I've heard of it. What's that all about?
Well, PTSD stands for post-traumatic stress disorder. It's a mental health condition. It's not a show of weakness on your part. It's not a character issue. It's not a training issue from the military. It's a disorder that some people will suffer from when they're exposed to traumatic events, either one big event or a series of events similar to what you would experience in combat.
So, is that something that I have or will it ever go away?
Well, it's something that I can help you with. It's a marathon and not a sprint. A disorder like that doesn't come about overnight. It came about over time. And I'm sure looking back, you can probably see stages of development with that. And it's going to take time to help fix those. But I feel like we can do that. We can minimize your symptoms, or maybe even get symptoms to go away over time. And take a partnership, though. You have to be willing to come and take part in the therapies that I recommend, but I'm committed to helping you with this.
I don't know if I'm ready for all this. I got a lot going on right now, and
I'm sure you
top do. Of this on, I don't know, Doc. I don't know.
I'm sure you do. Well, you're here for a reason. Obviously, is it safe to assume you're having trouble functioning right now, coping? Or you wouldn't be here with me today? Is that safe to assume?
Yeah.
Okay. Sadly, with PTSD, it doesn't just go away. And it doesn't get easier. Things will compound and maybe get worse. So I'm recommending that you come in at least once a week to sit and meet with me. We'll do some testing to determine the level of your disorder. And we'll set up some therapy, some one-on-one time where we can discuss and work through the issues you're having. And I can give you some great fixes that you can employ when you're having difficulties. Other things we can look at, I would like to get you involved in a group therapy session with other veterans where they will understand what you've been through, because I can't. And you can talk the language that you're used to other people who understand. Let me ask you a question, and I need honesty here, okay? Have you considered hurting yourself?
I have, Doc, but no one else knows about that.
I can respect that. That's a tough situation. And again, that's common with PTSD. Do you feel like you're going to hurt yourself now?
No.
Okay. So you don't have a plan or a timetable or anything like that set up?
No, that's just a thought, Doc.
Great.
If you understand, I'm just in a tight place.
I understand.
Nothing's going right for me right now.
Sure. Well, I'm going to try to help you, and hopefully it's going to be a lot better here soon. Well, have that candid talk with your family, though. Help them understand where you're at right now, the things that you're seeing, the things that you're feeling, and so that they, if they see progression with you getting worse, or if you do become suicidal, that they can reach out to me or to the hospital to get you more immediate help at a time.
Okay.
But if you're in agreement, I'll have my secretary set up an appointment next week and we'll get this process started. Just hang in there. I'm your partner through this and I'll help you through it. Thank you for coming today. No. I'm going to take good care of you.
Thanks for seeing me, Doc.
All right, Doc.
Thanks.
Remember, I'm your partner in this.
Yes, ma'am. I'd like to make a follow-up appointment to see Dr. Adams. If you can, put it on Friday's form.
Sure.
If you have anything early in the morning, that'll work fine for me.
Does 9 a.m. work for you?
Yeah, that's perfect.
So how'd your appointment go with Dr. Adams? I noticed you haven't mentioned it.
It was okay. He said something to the fact I got symptoms of PTSD and he wants to see me once a week. I don't know if I'm ready for that.
If going to see Dr. Adams is going to help you, I suggest you keep your appointments with him. You need to speak with someone about what you're feeling and what you're going through. I know you had a tough time overseas, but it'll only get better if you talk with someone.
I understand, but I don't want people thinking I'm crazy. And as soon as they know you've been to war, they start treating you different. I don't know if I'm ready for that.
No one's gonna treat you different. I know I won't. Look, just continue seeking help with Dr. Adams, okay?
Hey, I try, but hey. I'll be filling out some application next week. You know, I got the human resource experience, so try to find me a job.
Well, that's a start.
Yeah.
I'm sure you'll find something out there.
I sure do hope so. Everywhere. I thought veterans were supposed to have preference. I even went down to the local fast food restaurant. I ain't even heard back from them.
Marcus, listen. Listen, baby. You have to stay positive. You've got to stay positive. You'll find something soon. Tell Michelle.
Yeah, you've got to be patient, babe.
Patience? Been 6 months. I haven't heard from anybody. What am I supposed to do?
Oh, baby. Maybe you should try doing something you're passionate about. You love to draw and the paint. Maybe you should try one of those. Yeah? I guess.
What am I gonna do? How am I gonna do that? I ain't got no money for no design studio. Money don't grow on trees, so how am I gonna do that?
Marcus, wait a minute. Listen to this. How about you go back to school, you get a degree, and while you're getting a degree, you're gonna meet contacts, you're gonna meet people. And that way, by the time you're done, you'll have your degree, and you'll be doing something that you truly love to do, son. I mean, what do you think, Michelle?
What do you think is green?
Yeah, maybe that is an option.
No, that's a great alternative. And the number one thing is you'll be doing something you truly love to do. Can't get any better than that.
talent, son.
I think you should try it. It won't hurt.
Hello? Yes, this is Marcus. Hey, how you doing, Mr. Jones? Yeah. Oh, I'd love to come in. Okay, yes, I could be there Friday. 10 o'clock, yeah. Oh, thanks so much, sir. I appreciate this opportunity. All right, thank you. All right, bye. Hey, how are you doing, man? My name is Marcus Walters. I'm here to see Mr. Jones.
Okay, if you'll have a seat, I'll let Mr. Jones know that you're here.
Okay, awesome. Thank you.
Marcus?
Yes, sir.
Good morning, Mr. Walters.
How you doing, Mr. Jones?
Pleasure's mine. Please, right this way.
Yes, sir. Thanks, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Walters, again for coming. I have to say, you've got a mighty impressive resume. Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Hello? Yes? Hey, how you doing, Mr. Jones? Yeah. All right, well, thanks, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. All right, fine. Damn, man.
What's wrong?
That was Mr. Jones. I didn't get the job.
I'm sorry, babe. You'll find a job soon.
But baby, I need something now. School for direct graph design.
Congratulations!
Yeah, but I don't know if I can do this. You know what? Come on, Mom.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay.
Hey, Mom. You're not gonna believe this. I go to school next month. I'm starting to go to school, so you know that graphic design thing I was talking about? I'm actually gonna do it. Yep. Yeah. Let me call Jason. Let me check. See, I'm gonna call his mom. See if he's on the way in here. Okay. All right. Love you too, Mom. All right. Bye. Hey, Ms. Green. How you doing? This is Marcus. Yeah. Yeah. I was calling to check on Jason. See if you heard anything from him. What?
Suicide.
last night. I was up all night waiting on you. I called your mom. She said she hadn't seen or heard from you in a couple days. What's going on, Marcus?
I'm a grown man, you hear me? I don't need nobody checking me.
Checking you? Do you understand that your daughter is under my roof and now I'm checking you?
You don't gotta keep tabs on me, okay?
I mean, I understand that you've been different since you found out the news about your friend Jason.
Hey, you ain't gotta bring up there, you hear me? You need to calm down with that. I'm trying to deal with that the best way I can, you hear me?
I understand that, but it's not a positive way. I'm in this house, dealing with everything, while you're out there doing Lord knows what. Coming home all hours of the night, drinking all the time. How do you think that makes me feel? How do you think that makes Jay feel? Asking where her daddy is, and I don't have any answers for her. What am I supposed to do, Marcus? You have got to start understanding what your actions are doing to this family.
I'm sorry. Charlie, I'm the best way I can. It's just tough right now for me. This ain't easy.
I never said it would be easy. All I said was let me in. That's all you have to do.
This ain't easy. I'm trying. I'm trying.
Keep this business open if I don't have more clients. If I don't have more clients, I don't have no money.
You can't keep the clients you already have. Nobody wants to work with somebody smelling like a bottle.
What?
Don't act stupid. We've already had this conversation. I mean, I don't know how many times I have to keep telling you the same thing, Marcus. Something's gotta give. You're asking why the business is failing, but you have to look at yourself. I'm just saying, I can't keep maintaining this household by myself. That's why I called you.
Where is he?
There's been a lot going on lately, and we haven't been completely honest with you. So I wanted to talk to you and tell you about everything that's going on.
Everything's going on like what?
Well,
where?
Ever since Marcus has been back, he's been in therapy. But I called you because I don't think it's working.
Okay. Okay, what's going on? What is he doing?
He's staying out late at night, drinking all the time, and it's getting out of control. Even Jay, she keeps asking questions of why her dad's acting the way he's acting. I ran out of things to tell her.
Wait a minute, is my son doing drugs?
I don't know.
Why are you just now telling me this?
Because he told me not to tell.
Why did you do that? Why did you make that choice?
His decision. I had to respect him.
Michelle.
I'm sorry.
Where is Mark? Where is he? Oh my God. Okay, what are we gonna do?
I think
it may be time for someone else to intervene.
Oh my.
Oh man, what you doing this alley, old man?
I'm just on my morning stroll before I go to church. What's going on?
Can't catch a break. Girlfriend put me out, my business folded, and my best friend killed himself.
Oh man, I'm sorry to hear that, but things like this happen in life. You gotta pick yourself back up. You can't find salvation in that can right there, young man.
Oh man, what's your name is?
My name is Jason Whitmore. And your name is?
Jason?
Yes, Jason Whitmore.
My best friend's name is Jason. My name is Mark.
Nice to meet you, Mark. How about this alley, man? Stand up. Get up off this alley. There's nothing back here for you but trouble.
Sometimes that's how my life is.
That's part of life. That's why God put things in your life so you can start believing in Him. Okay? You can't do this by yourself. Trust me. In the morning, the same problem that you had today is going to be here tomorrow with that can. But you have just a little faith, the size of a mustard seed, in the faith of God. Everything will be okay, young man. Get about this alley, man. It's a better place for you. Come on, Gordon.
I tried. Hold on, let me get a little bit of that.
No, we done drinking. Put that down, man. We gonna drink something else today. Some cold water. Hey, get about this alley, man. Come on. Hey, boy, you're a big boy. Come on here.
Woo!
You got a new friend now.
You ain't too bad, man. What are you doing? Again, where you see you walking from?
We walk this aisle every Sunday morning. It's a little trail down here we walk in. But today, for some reason, God directed me up this alleyway. And ran into you. You're all right, young man. You're going to be okay. Come on, go with me. I got a place for you.
It's been rough, but I don't know who you is, old man, but some tell me you're a good guy.
I'm a good guy? Believe it, I'm a veteran, too.
Wow.
Yeah, Ghost Storm.
Come on, you know who's going to walk up here?
Get some of that drink over there, too?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Bring that with the water and soap. This ain't too good for me.
Why you help me out on
this? Well, almost 10 years ago, I was in the same predicament. But I met someone with big faith. They allowed me to have a little faith. Let our faith in God that we call this problem. It ain't like overnight, it's like boom, boom, boom. All your problems and troubles, it takes time. God doesn't need any help to work up strong. He created the earth in 7 days. 6 days, 6 on the 7th day.
name's Audrey and I'm a veteran.
My name is Jason, I'm a veteran.
My name's Mary and I'm a veteran.
My name is Fred and I'm a veteran.